He took another swig before walking toward me, and every muscle in my body tensed.
Gerard, I...
He pulled my head back by the hair. Yes? He planted his lips on mine, and I smelled the liquor in his mouth coming from his nose. Even after weeks of being at a convent, I couldn't have enjoyed his kiss. But I resisted the urge to pull away, my hands searching the top of the commode as he groped me with his free hand. Then, to my relief, I saw a cigar box on a bookcase a few paces away, and closed my eyes, waiting for him to finish. He panted for breath when he pulled away, and I boldly slipped out from under his compressing arms with his fingers still in my hair.
Is that how you greet all women, or just me?
Just you. He wiped his lips with the back of his hand. I rested my backside against the bookcase and tried to look as relaxed as I could. Gerard had been known to sense fear. I stretched my arms out, my fingers walking up the cigar box.
Just so we're clear, I'm not marrying anyone right now, I said.
Because you'll run away again?
I paused to think of a reason he'd believe, something only a selfish man like Gerard would understand.
There's too much going on with the war, truthfully. I could never have the reception I want, not with the rations getting more restrictive. We'd have to get everything from the black market, and I don't want anything black at my wedding.
Gerard reached for the box, laying his heavy hand right on top.
You would only think about yourself.
I pulled the box out from under his hand and opened it, offering him one of many cigars tucked inside. Gerard slammed the lid down.
Tell me, why'd it have to be a nunnery?
The nunnery, as you call it, gave me time to think. When I get married, it will be because I want to get married. Can't go to my father and expect it to be done,